want to bring in ABC's Jay O'Brien live from Capitol Hill for more on this. Jay, Speaker Kevin McCarthy says that he will let Santos on committees, just not the top ones. So how is that going to work? Because he's also saying that Santos needs to earn trust and is far away from that at this point.
When he just said that a moment ago in a press conference, Diane, saying that Santos has a long way to go to earn trust, he won't get on to primary committees, he won't get, as McCarthy says, any kind of security clearance or something of that nature, which some members of Congress do get because of their committee assignments. But Republicans are signaling, as they've been signaling over the last few days, that they want to handle the Santos problem internally. They do not want to publicly punish him. As we've heard from multiple members, I just spoke with a number of members today, they want the voters of Santos's district to be the ultimate deciders here. One exception to that are New York Republicans, some of Santos's fellow New York Republicans, a number of whom have come out and said that they want Santos to resign because he disrespected, deceived the voters of his district. So there are some members who are calling for Santos's ouster, but it is not Republican leadership right now. They are saying that he is seated, he is a member of the House GOP conference, and all of this is going to be taken up instead of real leadership by the Ethics Committee, Diane.
Well, and as you say, McCarthy says it'll be up to the voters. The voters won't get to make that call until 2024, but he does say that he will go before the Ethics Committee. So how does that process work?
Well, that is a long process. It's a drawn-out process. There is not much in the House rules. There's not much in the Constitution. There's not much in federal law that can oust a sitting member of the House of Representatives. Even if you get indicted or convicted of a crime, you can still be a member of the House of Representatives. Now, you can't sit on committees. House GOP rules say that if you're indicted, you can't sit on a committee, but you can still be a member of Congress. So there's not much they can do other than pressuring Santos to resign. And again, we have seen that GOP leadership does not have an appetite for that. One of the reasons that we've heard is that Republicans don't want to have a special election in Santos's district and put that district up for grabs, given their slim majority right now in the House.
You go. I want to ask about these two anti-abortion bills passed by the House majority. We heard House Speaker Kevin McCarthy touting this among the accomplishments in their first 5 days. But Senate Majority Leader Chuck Schumer is already saying this is doomed. Both of these bills are doomed in the Senate. So what exactly would these bills do, and what's the strategy if we already know they're not going to pass the Senate?
Well, their strategy is writ large, as we've seen with repeated bills coming out of the House, is what is called a messaging bill, which means it's a bill that passes with a message but is not necessarily intended to or thought to become law. So we saw it with the anti-abortion bills yesterday. We've seen it with repeated pieces of legislation coming out of the House this week, things that will likely be dead on arrival in the Senate because the Senate is controlled by Democrats. That is a high bar for House Republicans to clear, to get a piece of legislation that could pass in that Senate. So instead, what they're doing is they're passing legislation that will force the Senate's hand, force them to consider the issue, and it likely will die in that chamber. It is part of a continued strategy of House Republicans saying, look what we're doing on day one, not necessarily making a law, but pushing an issue. It's the other thing we're going to see when they open these continued investigations into President Biden, the Biden family, things of that nature. One of the things we've heard from House Republicans this week and last week is their priority, one of their biggest priorities, is not necessarily legislation, as much as it is oversight and investigations into this administration, Diane.
All right, Jay O'Brien, we appreciate it. Thank you.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.